It's kind of funny how they just make things up as they go along. Oh, record-breaking number of cases. We have to close all the bars and restaurants. But hey, you can still come to McDonald's. You can still come to our airports. The rules apply to you, not us. We still get to make money. We still get to cash out of the stock market early. We still get to profit off of your suffering. And the news has always been a psychological warfare operation. Now it's just comically apparent, and just watching 5 minutes of a news segment makes me want to make a video on current events. There's so many tactics and topics being thrown around to manipulate the general public into falling into the new global system like bees to honey. In the past weeks, we've seen strong usage of divide and conquer tactics through the BLM movement, which didn't work apparently. So now they're moving back to the Toyota Corolla. And we've seen divide and conquer between men and women, as we're seeing now with whites and blacks, young and old. They just don't want us united against them. It's absolutely insane. Just 3 weeks ago, Washington Square Park was filled to the brim with 10,000 people in an absolute trance about defunding the police for black rights, fighting for the good cause, and I spent $2,000. I wasted $2,000 handing out flyers to these thick-skulled morons. All of these aspects of manipulation can be explained by the Hegelian dialectic. They have an agenda, so they manufacture a threat. Then comes the police state and further slavery. Further slavery because we're technically already slaves, it's just they're taking away more and more. The most ridiculous trap people fall into is the Democrat versus Republican nonsense. The average IQ American joins the divide and conquer scheme, you know, letting them think they're picking a side, when in reality, these politicians are just a bunch of puppets, and all of those people are on the same side to manipulate the masses. Every single thing you're told is a distraction. It's why I focus on health, nutrition, and try to get people to open up their minds to what's important, because most people's values are the opposite. Once you become healthy, once you start thinking straight, once you feel good, then everything else comes. These things about health that I share to you guys for free are the elite people's secrets and part of their success. The majority of the things they do are simply to create fear and chaos. All the good little sheeple bent over like a bunch of sissy la la fairy boy vegans in their homes with giant Q-tips up their sad little butts. So to press even further, they created these fake riots, this fake movement, this fake news about how everyone's outside not wearing a mask and not wearing a mask. Oh, everyone's sick again. What's even crazier is how much the news flip-flops, because last week you couldn't find a newscast that wasn't talking about these protests. Now you can't find a newscast that isn't talking about the record-breaking cases. This incredibly contradictory behavior happens on more than one front. You know, the former being that the media is okay with everyone protesting outside, packed together like sardines. The latter being that they're opening things up, but saying cases are at an all-time high. It's the epitome of gaslighting, lying right to people's faces to maliciously deceive them. One sentence telling people we need to open up and get back to work, the next one saying cases are at an all-time high, it's still a threat, we better not open up again or we're gonna have to lock down. How does that make any sense? How can you lock down again if you're still locked down? That's like saying, oh, don't jump off a bridge when we're already drowning in the lake. They act as if they're concerned about small businesses and mom and pop shops. Talk negatively about, oh, Jeff Bezos can buy half the world and end world hunger. Then they ridicule people for going out to a bar and having a few drinks or any non-corporate store that stays open just to try to keep that moderate to small business alive. Speaking of sheeple, it is a little bit sheepish that they're spraying aluminum in the sky, you know, like secretively, so no one knows what's going on. If I had a hold of these cowardly pricks, I would beat them with an aluminum pipe so they know they're getting some aluminum. And these clowns know how stupid and gullible the masses are. It's like me talking about how great a vegan diet is, but then making fun of a bunch of vegan boys for being estrogenic sacks of soy slop. It's like me welcoming vegan boys in my DMs, but then All right, well, we're not going down that route. But the sheep will place so much value in the modern news as they would never be able to accept that their whole life is a manufactured illusion. Someone in my comments mentioned the term Pavlovian conditioning, and I'm sure there's a bunch of other terms we could use. It's a learning procedure where you get a biological entity, a human, a dog, a living being, to respond to a certain way due to conditioning. It's like teaching that dog to only eat when you blow a whistle. The powers at be are teaching the public to act in a certain way and to be complacent, like a bunch of sheep. You know, sheeple really is the perfect word. And there's a laundry list of these issues that's been going on and on and on. You know, global warming is one of the biggest ones. Get people to make food and lifestyle choices for the good of the planet, which relates back to the Hegelian dialectic, creating a fake problem to manipulate behavior to favor a police state. Don't you think it's funny that these vegan girls are living in apartments that are probably costing them $6,000 or $7,000 a month, but they won't use a plastic straw? They can manipulate the weather. This is like a bank robber holding a gun to your head and saying guns are the problem. No, I think you're the problem holding a gun to my head. Recently, we've seen so many fear-mongering things. The murder hornets, they tried to scare the crap out of people for a few days, use it as an excuse for the bees dying from the Wi-Fi. I did a whole video if you want to watch that. And there's also been more mainstream coverage of solar flares and solar minimums. Did a video on that as well. All of these tragedies, they are seemingly preparing the public for. Implant the idea in people's minds so when it happens, they accept it. Oh, this was supposed to happen. As opposed to questioning it. These people don't predict the future. They're writing the script. The Bible did not predict what's happening. They wrote the Bible. That's why it's happening, because they wrote it down and they're gonna do it. Whenever something happens, they are making people listen to and trust authority. The Bible is authority. If the overwhelming majority of people do so, anyone that doesn't is viewed as an outlier and attacked by the main populace. And I don't mean to bash on Christians, but the Bible is essentially a different form of mainstream conditioning that's trying to get you to think you're on the good side, but God isn't going to come down to save you. You have to save yourself. So the government doesn't have to deal with anyone opposing the mainstream agenda, specifically because their tactics, these forms of control, the fear-mongering, the chaos, the religion, whatever they're using, allow anyone opposing the mainstream to be labeled as a crazy schizophrenic. And I should have saved up the comments, but, you know, people literally try to call me crazy when I go very in-depth on science, about Wi-Fi, and various topics. So the average person has too low of an IQ to understand or be open-minded enough. They won't be able to comprehend why radiation from cell towers is harmful, why chlorine in the water is poison, or why aluminum in the air is a neurotoxin, because they have to go out and work very hard to even find that information in the first place, and there's so much mainstream agenda saying, no, it's fine, it doesn't matter. And that's if they're willing to listen. Most of the time, when you suggest anything outside of the modern media, they don't hold any value to what you're saying. You could basically give someone the secrets, all the secrets they would ever want to know to be successful in life, but if it's not coming from a position of authority, people will not care. As long as the modern media is able to instill fear and panic into the majority of the population, make sure that everyone is focused on material goods, instant gratification, complacence with modern life, we are a far cry from uniting together and making something better, a happier and healthier world. Modern government is a tyrannical dictatorship where the slaves are given the illusion they are free. 90% of the population is being guided in whichever direction they so choose. 5% of us realize what's going on, and the 5% that control the media and wealth are doing all they can to keep that 90% in their control. What makes it so difficult is they will throw in the truth here and there. They have all of these agents. You know, take the carnivore diet. Someone will tell you that eating liver is amazing and good for you, but then sell you an agrochemical glycine powder supplement or tell you that there's nothing wrong with grain-fed beef. They build your trust and relate to you, tell you the truth, but then flip right to their agenda and hope you take the bait. Most people, being gullible and naive, end up taking the bait. They trust the person and Therefore, then they believe what they're saying, and they go down that rabbit hole until something extreme enough happens for them to wake up and realize that person was deceiving them. I really don't know what's in store and what's specifically in their game plan. All I know is I grow more and more disgusted every single day by all of these influencers who sold their souls for a pathetic paycheck. I think a couple months back, I made a video talking about how this whole ordeal would last 18 months to symbolize 666. And I speculate that this will be until the end of next year, not this year. Then, hey, maybe we do have a few years of breathing room. Maybe they realize this went so well, they're just gonna accelerate the full-on New World global system. I'm genuinely curious how this is going to pan out, and I'm concerned about the tactics they're going to use to force people into doing things. Don't want to buy our plant-based Beyond Meat slop? Oh, okay then. We'll just point some Wi-Fi towers at your meat plants, at your cattle, make everyone sick, kill all the animals. So then there won't be anything besides our Beyond Meat slop on the shelves. Don't want to get an injection of aluminum and mercury into your arm, right into your bloodstream? Oh, that's okay. You just can't travel anywhere and have to stay inside your home. Don't want to get a Q-tip shoved 2 feet up your nose to get tested? Oh, then you can't work a job because you're dangerous to everyone else around you. That's the world that we're living in. I don't think it's what we're moving towards. I think it's already here. And no one wants to talk about it. The few people that do are already so censored, and you know, there's not really much that can be done. So thank you guys for watching me. Hopefully you guys can drop a like, share the video. We'll do a live stream later at 3 p.m. Eastern time, unless I have some plans. If not, we'll do the live stream later sometime at night. So if I do end up going to the beach, we'll do the live stream later. If not, I'll see you guys at 3 p.m. Have a good night.